Welcome back to another VTScada training video. This is the fourth video in the Parameterized page series. In this video, we focus on user-defined widgets. You get lots of widgets in the VTScada Idea Studio, but sometimes you want even more. For example, here I've drawn an analog status tag using three different widgets. The odds are good, I'm going to want even more of these. I could copy and paste, but then I'd need to link several widgets to the next analog status tag, and I'd rather do this in one step. This is a job for a tag widget. Just select the existing widgets, right-click to open the pop-up menu, choose Group, then New Widget, give it a name that describes what it is, ensure that New Tag Widget is selected, check the tag selection, more about that soon, and click OK. And now I have a new way to represent any analog status tag. Now, before we go any further, we need to review the grouping options. There's Group, but that's great for moving stuff around on the screen, but it's a bad choice for building a library of widgets, mostly because you cannot name groups, and they're not added to the palette. Then there are standard or plain widgets. Those are useful if you have a few shapes and images that you want to reuse. Plain widgets do get names, and they are added to the palette, but they cannot easily be linked to a tag, so don't use those when you want to draw tags. Finally, there are tag widgets. Now that's what I'm talking about. Here's another example using the pump from the last few videos. All the widgets shown in this selection are linked to child tags of pump 1. Start the group process and choose tag widget. Give it a name. Check the link. This time, it's to the first common parent of all the selected tags. That's pump 1, which makes perfect sense. Finish creating the widget. And now it's easy to draw pump 2. Just one step, and all the I/O tags are included. One more time, but with a wrinkle. In this case, one widget represents the level in the tank, and the other represents flow filling the tank. Continuing on to create the tag widget, the first common parent is the driver. Oh, that makes no sense, so stop. No, really, stop. Those two widgets do not represent a Modbus driver. You have a choice here between two options. If there is a parent tag further up the tree that the selection does represent, well, then you can select it. In this example, that does make sense. Level and flow are properties of a station. Your other option is to create a new context tag under the driver and move these two tags below it, hopefully turning that new context into a named type. Then you can start again choosing the new type. So then what happens when it comes time to improve your widget? Just right-click on any instance of the widget and choose Edit. You could also open it the same way you would open any page in the Idea Studio. By the way, if you had groups nested within widgets, you would have to repeat the edit command all the way down. Be careful. Every change you make will also happen immediately to every copy of the widget. While we're here, look at the properties of any of the widgets within the group. Note that instead of being linked to a specific tag, it uses what's called the linked tag, or perhaps a child of the linked tag. That is what makes the widget flexible. If you add new widgets to an existing tag widget, you must edit the properties to follow the same pattern. There's more that you can do, but I'll leave that for the documentation. Now it's time to move on to the last video in the Parameterized page series.